Hello everyone, good morning students. Dear students, in previous class we take and discuss a very important chapter of your syllabus, which is quadrilaterals. And in previous classes we discuss all the important theorems, all the important questions of your NCERT exercise solve related to the chapters quadrilaterals, and we completed the exercise. Now in today class we take and discuss start a very important chapter of your syllabus, which is Heron's formula. Dear students, this is one of the most important chapter of your syllabus, so please dear students concentrate on this chapter. Dear students, basically in this chapter we calculate the area of the triangles. So Heron's formula related to find the area of triangle when its all three sides are given. Dear students, we also aware about the so many formula, some other important formula to find the area of the triangles. Like that, you know that very well. Suppose that ABC be a triangle. The concept of area means according with the help of the Heron's formula we generally find the area of triangle ABC. What is the area? Area is the region that occupied by any triangular shape triangle. So that region and the region occupied by that triangle is known as area. So we calculate the area of the triangle. Now dear sir, we know that some other important formula related to triangle. The common form of triangle is what? Suppose that ABC is a triangle. Okay, and let us say AD perpendicular to BC. Let us consider ABC is a triangle in which AD is perpendicular to BC. AD is perpendicular to BC, and let its base BC. BC is base. Let us take as X. Let us take the base as X and its height, that is AD. This is take as H. H unit. So first of all, we draw a triangle. We take a triangle ABC in which BC is our base, which is take as X, and AD is our height, which is take as H. Now the common formula to obtain the area of triangle ABC. So general formula to find area of triangle ABC is equal to 1 upon 2 into base into height. Dear friend, if in any triangle we have base as well as height, then we know that this is a very important formula. This is the common formula to find the area of triangle ABC. In previous classes you already know about that formula, and you also solve so many questions based on using that formula, means 1 upon 2 base into height. So according to this figure, so 1 upon 2 into base into x and height is h. So this is square unit, because of you know that area always in square unit. So this is the common formula to find the area of triangle ABC. This is not a Heron's formula, but in that class we discuss about the chapter Heron's formula. Dear students, Heron's formula is applicable in that type of questions in which all of its sides, different sides are given. Okay, either in escalene triangle or in isosceles triangle. Okay, but in right angle triangle. But in that formula generally. Because of in right angle triangle, we always have the height and base. So if we have a height and base, then we using that formula. If we have all three different sides of a triangle, like 13 centimeter, 14 centimeter, and 15 centimeter, then in that condition we apply the Heron's formula. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the Heron's formula and what is the concept of Heron's that formula. Let's see. Let's see. Dear friends, now suppose that there is A, B, C, be an escalene triangle in which the side opposite to angle A is A, the side opposite to angle B is B, and the side opposite to angle C is C. Means in triangle ABC, let us consider for triangle ABC sides BC is equal to A unit, AC is equal to B unit, and AB is equal to C unit. Suppose that in that triangle all of its different sides are given. Okay, now and we find what area of triangle ABC, then in that type of question in which all of its three different sides are given, then we apply the Heron's formula. Okay, thus area of triangle ABC is given by the formula under root S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Here S is semi perimeter of the triangle ABC, where S is what? The semi perimeter of the triangle ABC, which is defined by the formula S equal to A plus B plus C upon 2. A plus B plus C upon 2, which is defined by the formula semi perimeter, now dear friends. And you know that very well, what is the concept of perimeter? You know that the sum of its all sides of any geometrical figure is known as perimeter. So half of the perimeter is known as what? Semi perimeter. So this is the half of the perimeter, because of A plus B plus C is what? The perimeter of the triangle ABC, na? Sum of its all sides. So semi perimeter is what? Half of the perimeter. And ABC, you know that all three different sides of the triangle ABC. So dear friend, this is the formula. This is called the Heron's formula. This formula is known as Heron's formula. In this way, we can say that Heron's formula is used for finding the area of triangle ABC when its all three different sides are given. Okay. So this is one of the most important formula related to that chapter. Now we take and solve some important questions based on Heron's formula. Let's see. And the question is find the area of triangle
ABC, whose sides are 13 centimeter, 14 centimeter, and 15 centimeter, respectively. Okay.
Find the area of triangle ABC, whose sides are 13 centimeter, 14 centimeter, and 16 centimeter, respectively.
Now let's see its solution. Now, here let first side A is what 13 centimeter, B is what 14 centimeter, and third side is what 15 centimeters.
Now, first of all, we find the semi-perimeter of the triangle, that is
the semi perimeter of triangle ABC. That is S is equal to A plus B plus C upon 2.
This is the formula to find the semi perimeter of the triangle ABC.
So S is equal to what? So 13 plus 14 plus 15 upon 2, that is what? 8. So 42 upon 2, that is what? 21. So the semi perimeter is 21 centimeter.
Now, what I do? Now we apply the Heron's formula. Thus
by Heron's formula, area of triangle ABC is given by the formula under root S minus A, S minus B, and S minus C.
S we already calculated from there.
Now we putting in the values. S is what? 21 into 21 minus A is 13 into 21 minus B is what? 14 into 21 minus C is what? 15.
Now we simplify them. Okay,
so we get as what? 21 into 21 minus 13 is 8 into 21 minus 14, 7. 7 into 21 minus 15, 6. Now let's see. We can write 21 as 7 into 3. Okay, 8. We can write 8 as 4 into 2. We write 7 as it is, and we write 6 as 3 into 2. 3 into 2. Now let's see.
So first of all, we factorizing them, and now
7 is in pair, so 7 is common out from the surface. Okay, 3 is also in pair, 3 is also common from the under root. And the square root of 4 is what? 2. And 2 is also in pair, so 2 is common out from the under root.
So under root is cancelled.
Now we multiply them. 7 3 is 21 into 2 2 is 4. Now 4 1 is 4, 4 2 is 8 centimeter square. Thus, in this way,
the area of the required triangle, the area of the required triangle is 84 centimeter square. 84 centimeter square. Okay, because of, you know that very well, ki area always in square unit. Area always in square unit. So this is the very, very important question related to the formula. Area of Heron's formula, related to Heron's formula. Now let's see once more time. In that question, we find the area of triangle ABC whose sides are given, which is 13 centimeter, 14 centimeter, and 15 centimeter. 13 we take as angle A, side ABC we take as, and we now first of all we find the semi perimeter of the triangle. After finding the semi perimeter of the triangle, we apply the Heron's formula. And Heron's formula, you know that very well, as S minus A, S minus B, S minus C in under root. Now we put all the values and simplify them. In this way we get our result. So in this way, when you have the three sides of the triangle, you apply that formula and simplify in this way. Now we take and solve some other important questions based on these topics.
Now the
The next question is
find the area of triangle. Find the area of triangle whose two sides are 18 centimeter and 10 centimeter. And the perimeter is 42 centimeter. Perimeter is 42
centimeter.
Now let's see the solution.
Dear friend, this is also the very important formula. Very important questions based on area to find the area of the triangle. And in that question, we have two sides. But in Heron's formula, we know all three sides now. Then we apply that formula. So first of all, let us consider
8/3 side B.
Okay, now first two sides is given.
Is suppose that A is equal to 18 centimeter and another side B is equal to what? 10 centimeter. And perimeter is given is 42 centimeter. Now,
dear friend, you know that very well. The perimeter is what? Sum of its all sides.
Since we know that perimeter is equal to
sum of its all sides,
means A plus B plus C, that is perimeter we put as 42. A is what? 18. B is what? 10 centimeter. And C we find that.
Okay, now
from here we have 42 is equal to, this is what? 28 plus C. So C is equal to 42 minus 28. So C is equal to 14 centimeter.
So in this way, that's when first of all, what we find? First of all, we find its third side. Because of, you know that very well, Heron's formula is applicable for only when three sides of the given of a triangle is given. After that we apply the Heron's formula. So in this way we find all three sides of the triangle. A, B and C. Okay. So now what we find? Now we find the semi-perimeter. Now
the semi perimeter S is, now
the semi perimeter is half of the perimeter,
means perimeter by 2. Perimeter by 2, that is 42 by 2, that is 1. This is what? 21 centimeter.
Okay, so in this way we find the also the value of semi perimeter. Now what I do? Now this will be apply the Heron's formula. Thus by Heron's formula.
Area of required triangle is what? In under root.
What is the formula here, dear friends?
In under root is S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. Now we put all the values. S is what? 21. S minus A is 21 minus A is what? 18. Into S minus B, 21 minus 21 minus 3 is what? 14.
So dear friend, first of all, we put up all the values in that formula. Now we simplify them. Let's see.
So we have 21 into 21 minus 18, that is 3, into 21 minus 10, that is 11, into 21 minus 14, this is 7. Now what I get? We get as 7 is a 21. So 21 into 21 into 11.
So what I could do, friends?
So here we observe that 21
is in pair.
So we take 21
common out from the square root.
So 21 and under root in under root 11 is there.
So 21 under root 11
is square centimeter. Square centimeter. This is the
required solution of the given question. So in this way you can solve each and every question, dear friend, of your syllabus based on Heron's formula. First of all you revise each and every question which we discuss in that class. After that you complete your NCRT exercise based on that topic. Okay, now dear friend, we take and solve one more question based on Heron's formula. Let's see. Now we take a very important question of your NCERT exercise based on Heron's formula. Let's see.
And the question is, sides of the triangle are, sides of the triangle are in the ratio, in the ratio 12:17:25,
and its perimeter
is 540 centimeters. Okay, find its area. Find its area.
This is the question here. This is also a very important question. Let's see its solution.
Dear friend, here the ratio of
sides of the triangle are given. Okay. So first of all, let us consider
the sides are a is equal to 12x, b is equal to 17x, and c is equal to 25x respectively.
Okay. Because of the sides given are in ratio, thus and perimeter is given, na?
And perimeter is given as 540 centimeter.
And we know that the perimeter is for sum of its all sides.
That is 540 is equal to a plus b plus c. Now, so a is what? 12x plus 17x plus 25x is equal to 540.
Okay. Now we simplify them. So we get, now let's see. So in this way, dear students, we find the value of x as what? 10. Okay. Now, we find all its three sides. Thus,
all sides of the required triangle, the required triangle A is equal to what?
This is 12x
means 12 into 10, that is 120 centimeter. Second side, this is 17x, that is 17 into 10, 170 centimeter. Third side C is what? 25x, that is 25 into x is what? 10, which is what? 250 centimeter. Now
we find all of its three sides,
which is 120 centimeter, 170 centimeter, and 250 centimeter.
Now we also find the semi perimeter.
Now semi perimeter S is what? Half of the perimeter means 540 upon 2. That is what? 2 to the 4. That is 270 centimeters.
So in this way we find all the required things which we find for finding the area of triangle. Now we apply the Heron's formula.
Thus area of triangle ABC is equal to under root,
we apply the formula, Heron's formula,
S minus A, S minus B and S minus C.
Now we put all the values.
So S is what? 270 into 270 minus A, 120. Okay, now 270
minus
B, 170. Okay, into now 270 minus what? C, 250.
Okay, now we simplify them.
So we have in under root 270, write as it is. 270 minus 20 is 0, 7 minus 2 that is 5, 2 minus 1 that is 1, 150. Okay, now here 170 means 100 is left. Now into here 270 minus 250, that is 20 is left.
Now let's see.
Dear friends, 9, the square root of 9 is what? 3. 3 is in pair, so we take 3 is common out from the surface. 25, the square root of 25 is what? 5. 5 is also common out from the surface. The square root of 100 is 10, so 10 is common out from the surface. The square root of 4 is what? 2. 2 is also common out from the surface. And what is the left value? This is 10. We can write 2 into 5. And this is 2. And this 5. So, no, is 90 into 10. Okay, 90 into 10 into 2 is 2, this 5 is also common. So, 90 into 10 into 10, that is 9000 centimeter square. This is the required solution.
Okay, thus, dear friend, in this way, today's class, we take and solve some important question of your NCERT exercise, NCERT syllabus based on the Heron's formula. Now, so first of all, you revise all the questions which we discussed in that class and complete your NCERT exercise. Okay, dear students, now in next class, we take and solve some other important questions related to Heron's formula and complete the NCERT exercise. Okay, now thanks to all.